So let's look at the process of storyboarding. And for this, let me explain by using the example of this Timeless Life Skills Foundation website that I had created. So this is the website, but let me take you behind the scenes and show you how I storyboarded this website. So I started by doing a target audience definition, and I said that the target audience is largely divided into two categories. We've got the teachers, the students, the parents, principals, etc. on the one hand, and we've got volunteers, donors, partners on the other. And then the needs analysis, for example, for the teachers, the idea is that they should figure out why teaching life skills is becoming really important and how they can do that by starting clubs and labs, life skills clubs and labs at their school. For the students, I said that it's important to understand the context of the 21st century, how it is changing, and how skills like self-directed learning are becoming really critical, as also the dispositions that they need to shine in the 21st century. Then for volunteers, for example, I said that we could seek their help to create some content or maybe conduct some workshops. And for the donors, basically appeal to them to help fund the operations of Timeless Life Skills. And I broadly defined that what we have to explain in the website are these factors. Why Timeless Life Skills? What are Timeless Life Skills? How do we work? And a call to action to the donors and to the volunteers. Then I started storyboarding this website, visually thinking how I think the website will finally look. And I thought that the first website will just be a single page scroll down website. And on the top, for example, there will be a header, and the header will have logo and the name, and it will have the navigation. And this will be followed by a slider, basically four or five large images that will come, and they will explain the essence of Timeless Life Skills. There will be some social share buttons, and then we will define why Timeless Life Skills, what are Timeless Life Skills, how do we work, for whom, and so forth. Scrolling down further, there will be another section where we will define the pedagogy or the design approach that we follow. And I will come back to this idea of a layered cake of education later. And then there will be a section on courses where all the courses that we will create to help students and teachers run life skill clubs or learn life skills, those will appear. For example, this course that you are taking right now. Having this visual sense of what the website will look like, I then figured out exact sections that will appear. So I said on the top there will be a header, then there will be sliders, then we will explain why Timeless Life Skills and what are Timeless Life Skills. Then we will give some information about Timeless Life Skills Foundation, the charity, what we do, and then talk about the workshops and courses that we offer and explain our learn design. And you will notice that later I said that let's swap these two and let's explain the learn design, the layered cake first, and then talk about the workshops and clubs that we offer. And of course, for credibility, it's very important to give some testimonials. So that was the section here on testimonials. And then we will have a call to action, which will be for the volunteers to seek their help in creating content or conduct workshops and maybe seek some donations online. Then there will be a section which will be the social media links and urging our viewers to talk about Timeless Life Skills. Then there will be a section on contact us, how can the audience get in touch with us, and maybe a footer. So with this schematic and storyboard ready, let me show you how the final website looks like and how it aligns with this storyboard. So this is how the website looks. On the top, there is our logo, the name, and the menu, and the navigation. And the navigation here is what is called the hamburger navigation, which looks better on small interface devices like smartphones and tablets. And if you click, it gives you all the sections on this page. Then we have the sliders. And the sliders are five large images that explain the essence of Timeless Life Skills. And then, of course, if you scroll down, here is a big message saying what Timeless Life Skills Foundation does is make the youth future ready. Then we are explaining the why Timeless Life Skills. And you will recall that in my storyboard, I had imagined that these will be a set of videos, but finally I decided to go with GIFs. And in just three simple GIFs, I'm explaining why Timeless Life Skills. Then further down, here is another big headline which says what Timeless Life Skills Foundation does is make the youth life ready. And then adhering to the storyboard, we are talking about what are timeless life skills. And here is a poster I created for this to say that here are future ready skills like learning to learn, learning to think, etc. And life ready skills, learning to be, leadership, emotional intelligence, and so forth. And then dispositions that are really important to shine in the 21st century. And this is the approach. This is that layered cake. And I will come back to the layered cake in a bit. Then we have a section on about timeless life skills, what we do, workshops, remote mentoring, videos and courses, lectures, teacher training, and so forth. And here is a sense of the work that we have been doing, the workshops that we conduct. Then there is information about the clubs that we run, like, you know, the Young Innovators Club or the STEM Club or the Digital Media Literacy Club, of which this website making tutorial is a part of this Digital Media Literacy Club. Then we've got a YouTube channel, Facebook, blog, publications, ebooks, e-comics, etc. And this is the testimonial. Very important, credibility-wise. People we work with, what do they think about our work? So there are all kinds of people's quotes that have been given here. Then students' gratitude. What do students think about our work? Media coverage, important to establish credibility. And this is that call to action that I mentioned. This is the call to action to volunteers to say that if you want to volunteer with us, drop us a message and we will get in touch. Here is the social media bar, which in the original plan was on the top left, but finally I put it down here. And then finally the footer, email us. And also you can follow us on our Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, etc. Let me show you a couple of more examples of storyboarding. So I like to storyboard, and I had storyboarded the some of the elements of the website that I just showed you. For example, this is the storyboard of the top sliders on the website. And so the idea here was that in 4 or 5 big photographs with little bit of text, what I wanted to explain to the audience was how Timeless Life Skills is all about making the underserved children and youth future ready and life ready. Here is another example of a storyboard. The layered cake that I was showing you, which is a metaphor I have used to explain the learned design behind the Timeless Life Skills workshops. Here is one last example. So for this course, I had also developed a flyer, and for the flyer also, I had created a storyboard. So in the storyboard, I was trying to visualize what is the key message we want to convey in the flyer. And what we were saying is that in the process of building a website, what the benefits you derive are that you improve your self-expression, you learn certain life skills, and digital media literacy is a vocational skill 2.0. And in developing the website, you will develop comfort with technology. And once I had storyboarded this, then the flyer looked like this. And once the flyer was ready in English, I also converted that into Hindi, which brings us to my final point, that once you have developed a website in one language, you can also create that in another language. For example, this is an older version of Timeless Life Skills website in Hindi. And once you have developed a website in English, it's easy to create multiple language versions of the same website. So I hope this gives you a sense of how to storyboard, how to visualize what you think your website will look like, and then sketch it out so that when you get down to actually designing your website, you have a better idea of what to do.